Live in 10. 5, 4, 3.
Welcome to the LUSLBUS.
This is season 2.
In our first episode, we're covering women's football. And it's a huge match, LSE first versus UCL first.
Certainly is. We've sent our reporters Tom and Jason down to LSE to pick up the home team.
When's the bus coming? We're going to be late.
Wait, guys, I can hear it.
Made it. We're at Berrylands, the home of LSE football. We're minutes from kickoff for season 2 of the bus.
Okay, let's look at some of the key players in this matchup today from UCL and from LSE. What do you think, Tom?
So starting with LSE, we've got Kelly. She's a forward. She's 22. She's a master's student. I've got some of her stats here. We can have a look. So preferred foot, foot-long sub.
Not sure what she means.
I don't get that one.
Not sure that's a football term.
No, that's gone straight over my head. Favourite football team, either Texans or the USWNT. I mean, I she's speaking in riddles. I don't know what this means.
Yeah, lots of letters, no idea.
No idea.
And what about UCL?
I'm glad you've asked. For UCL, we've got Mia Taylor. She plays in midfield. Let's have a look and see what she is saying. We have, as I said, centre midfielder, history student, first year.
Right. Fresher.
Fresher, right-footed. Favourite football team is Arsenal. Well, I suppose someone has to.
Bayern Munich likes them.
They do. Favourite movie is The Truman Show. Are you familiar with that?
I don't think I've seen it, no.
No, me neither. Favourite ice cream, raspberry.
Thanks for that, Tom. Oh, I've just got, Jason is pitch side with the two UCL captains. Let's cut down there now.
I'm Christina Sofianos. I study archaeology and anthropology, and I play centre back.
I'm Jess Wadey. I study maths and physics, and I play centre mid. Yeah, we haven't played them yet this season, but they've always been in our league, so I've been here 3 years and we've played them, well, 6 times. I'm going to go with 3-0.
3-0 to
UCL.
You guys are co-captains, so how does that work? Explain that to us.
It's every other game.
Yeah.
Do you have different responsibilities, or do you just help each other out?
No, just help each other out. We're two, really. Yeah, we've been together for 3 years now, so our partnership's quite strong.
Great to hear from Christina and Jess down there. Last thoughts before the match, who's going to come out on top today, Tom?
It's a tough one. UCL obviously won the league last year, so they're a strong team. But LSE have got home advantage, so I'm going to have to go for a draw.
I can't wait anymore. Let's cut down to our commentators. Thanks very much, Jason. And we're here pitch side. We're about to kick off. So UCL in light blue, ready to kick off. Mia Taylor, our player to watch, ready with the ball.
Here we go. We're off. LSE with the ball, working it down the wing. Into Kelly. Oh, it's a good pass forward.
Straight onto the captain, Ipo, who makes a run. Oh, great tackle. Well in.
Well covered by the UCL centre-back there.
LSE working up the right wing here.
Work it out wide. It's a chase down the wing. It's a good interception from the defender there. This game really is a six-pointer. LSE have won the ball back, and it's a long ball forward from the centre-back for Epo to chase. And shoots into the side netting.
Oh, well, what a shame.
Can't help but feel, Jason, if that was on target, it would have been a goal.
I know, it was a brilliant penetrating run that from the captain.
It looks like UCL are being forced into an early change here. That's the right winger, Simone, who looks like she's picked up a bit of a hamstring problem.
Oh, Hammy.
Hammy has indeed gone. Fortunately for UCL, they've got a very good squad on paper, so they've got a substitute ready and waiting.
Here we see LSE's coach, Alex Riley. He's wearing the bobble hat, and it is needed today, isn't it, Tom?
It is. I mean, these pictures, I feel, are not getting across the full extent of the rain and the cold and the wind. I think football should be a summer sport. UCL on the attack. Oh, that's a good shot coming in from Mia, but it's safely palmed round the post by the goalkeeper. That's going to be a corner.
Safe hands!
And it's headed away by LSE, straight to the number 13, and you can now bring it forward. She's running, running, it's a good counter, up to Epo. Running, running, still running, taking them all on, still running, still running. Oh no, cleared away, but good break from LSE there.
Think she could have done with a pass there, Tom.
Slight miscontrol left from LSE. Mia with the throw. Oh no, she doesn't fancy it. Jess throws it in instead. Up to the winger.
Oh, handball, handball!
Oh,
referee.
Surely, referee! It's not been given. And it's cleared away.
Oh, that was shocking.
That is a big call. LSE working the ball through the midfield, over to Kelly, and oh!
She takes a tumble.
She is down. She is back up again. That looked contentious. Let's take a look at the replay.
Okay, here she is, takes the ball. Oh, that is harsh from the number 10 there. What do you think, Tom? Do you think that was intentional?
It's difficult to say. I mean, I think the number 10 did get the ball, but it was definitely a very rough challenge. So we've got LSE's midfielder Tiff Alves taking part in the wall here, which is quite a surprising decision given that she's only 5'2".
Jess Wadey floats it over Tiffany Alves' head.
Told you.
And it's a goal!
Oh, it's in!
Oh,
1-0.
30th minute, first goal.
Incredible strike from Jess there. She really does know where the goal is.
And what a time to score, always important here, in the first half to get ahead and take the lead.
And at the end of the day, goals win games. This could be very important.
What a half! The score is 1-0 to UCL. We've got our football analyst Adam here to talk us through that key moment.
Thanks, Jason. It really was a fantastic free kick. The way she got the ball up, over the wall and into the top corner, the goalie had absolutely no chance.
Striker!
Absolutely inspired. What a half for UCL, but let's see if LSE can bring it back in the second half.
Coaches have done their team talks and the second half is underway.
Match update. At the start of the second half, Mia Taylor, the UCL player to watch, is still pulling the strings in midfield.
It's 1-0! It's huge! It's 1-0 in the 53rd minute. It's Epo, the LSE captain, has gone straight through the defence, beaten three defenders, and she's put it in the corner. 1-1. Oh, it's still over half an hour left. It's anyone's game.
All to play for. We've got another free kick here for UCL. Captain Jess about to take it.
And gets it over the wall. Oh, well caught by the keeper. I actually believe this is the LSE goalkeeper's first game for the first team. So
yeah,
she's
usually a reserve.
Putting in a very strong performance so far.
She has been an integral part of the back four here today, doing an outstanding job.
Jason, no, we'll have to interrupt you. Sorry there, mate. It appears the ball has gone in the goal.
Oh, I think she's missed that one. Oh my gosh, it's a huge moment in the game. What a turnaround. It's an LSE penalty in the 85th minute.
It's a goal! It's a great penalty. She knows where the goal is and they're jogging back, ready for kickoff. 5 minutes to go. Can they get an equaliser?
3-2 to UCL. Let's go, LSE.
LSE on the attack. Also, we've only got 3 minutes left now. They really need to get a goal as soon as possible.
LSE's coach, Alex Riley, shouting instructions all over the pitch, trying to rally his troops and see if something else can happen to at least make it an equaliser.
He's looking, he has got the face of a man who is stressed. There can't be much time left. Oh, in fact, there we are. The referee's just blown the final whistle. So it's a final score of 3-2 to UCL. I have to say, it was a great game. LSE couldn't quite pull it back.
Yeah, I know. I really thought they had a chance there after that penalty to bring them back to 3-2.
That penalty at the end, 5 minutes to go, it was very, very exciting. But on this occasion, UCL have hung on, defended well, and they're going to be getting the 3 points.
Absolutely. What did you think UCL's key strengths were today that took them over the finish line just before LSE could bring it back?
I mean, they defended very well. They made the most of their set pieces. That was big, obviously. They had the free kick in the first half. The midfield was very strong. LSE did very well to get back into it. For a while there, it looked like it could have been a cricket score.
Oh, hold on. This just in. We've got the LSE coach and captain down pitch side. Let's have a look at what they have to say.
Well, we lost 3-2, but I guess we gave it a shot.
Yeah, no, UCL are a really good side, but I think we were robbed today, really. And, you know, definitely deserve a penalty. Nice to put away. It's a shame there's only 5 minutes left before we can get the equaliser.
I thought we played really well, but we could improve. I mean, it's the second game of the season, and we've still got training to look forward to.
Yeah, got one or two things to work on, but I think, you know, next time we play them at their place, we'll definitely be able to return the favour. So yeah, it should be a good game. Look forward to it. We definitely got our eyes on the LUSL Cup final. We've had a really good season in Bucks and in LUSL, so just making sure we're near the top of the tables.
Second place. First place?
First place.
What a way to start season two of the LUSLBUS.
Indeed, what a game. 3 points for UCL. That was football.
And this is LUSL.